this video, let's take a look at the BigCommerce Page Builder and use some of the basic widgets to create amazing storefront layouts. In the leftmost side of the window, you can go through the widgets, layers, and edit the theme style settings. And at the bottom left corner, you will find the option to switch to viewing the live store. At the top left corner, there is a drop-down which shows the page you are currently working on. You can also select and switch to other web pages available in your store. You can also create a new page directly in the Page Builder. With the Page Builder, you can easily switch between design and preview modes. Preview mode allows you to work as if you are on the live site. By using the preview mode, you can see how the changes you made will look like on the storefront before publishing them and having them take effect on the live site. A good thing about the Page Builder is you can easily toggle between desktop, tablet, and mobile previews, allowing you to see how responsive your site will be on different devices. Let's look at the basic widgets BigCommerce has provided out of the box. The first one is the layout widget. This allows you to create a layout style where you can place other widgets. You can choose between 1 to 6 column layout. You can also do simple styling to your layout like adjusting margin, padding, background, and borders. It will be helpful to rename your layout widget so that you can easily identify and locate it in the layer section later on. Another commonly used widget is the text widget. With the text widget, you can add text elements to the storefront layout. For more control and customization, you can select Custom Text Style to open up the typography options. Let's try adding images to the layout. With the Image widget, you can choose existing images in the library, upload new images, or pull images from URLs. The Image widget also has a built-in option to implement a parallax style. Aside from common styling options, you can also add links and alt properties to your images for SEO purposes. To move widgets around, open the layer section and grab the handlebar next to the widget you wish to move. You can simply drag and reorder the widgets inside their respective columns or move them to different layouts or regions of the page. With the Hero Banner widget, you can create banners that combine images, videos, titles, and text content with a call to action button. You can edit and style the background image, text content, and button elements of the widget in the same way you would, as if they were separate widgets. With a bit of imagination and creativity, you can utilize the styling and visibility of the widget elements to create many different kinds of banner designs. In the Cornerstone theme, there is already a built-in carousel in the home page. Still, you can create a new one via the carousel widget, which you can place in any page you like. If you want, you can remove the title, content, and button elements to create a carousel consisting purely of images. Add, delete, and rearrange the order of the slides as you see fit. Next, let's look at the video widget. This is a very useful widget, especially for e-commerce sites. It allows you to embed videos into your page by just inputting the video link into the widget. You can then toggle between activating autoplay and video loop, as well as displaying and hiding video controls. The next two widgets, the product and product set widgets, are very useful in any e-commerce store. With these widgets, you can readily pull info from the store's product catalog and create simple product cards which you can place anywhere in the page. You can use this product card or product set to highlight specific products which you want to promote to the site visitor. With the product set widget, you will have to manually select the items to be included in the set. If you wish to have a dynamically populated product set, you may have to create your own custom widget or app for this. You can keep adding products to the set. If the total number of products selected exceed the indicated number of products per slide, the product set is automatically displayed as a carousel type. The button widget allows you to easily create a button which you can link to do any action you may want. You can also style button hover states in this widget and change the button's border styles. Use the HTML widget to inject your own custom HTML to the store layout. Just be careful in using this to make sure that your HTML code does not conflict or break any other code in the theme. Lastly, we have the spacer and divider widgets. Use these widgets to add space or line breaks between sections in your storefront. By creatively combining these different widgets, you can already create many common use cases and layouts for e-commerce stores. So start playing around and discover how to make the most out of your e-commerce site.